We're talking now with a regular guest here on Proactive Investors. That's Paul Kavanagh from Killik & Company. Paul was one of the most accurate forecasters of the FTSE 100 last year, coming in with an expected figure at the end of the year at 58.50. We weren't too far away from that. Paul, welcome. In the context of last year's forecast, you've got a forecast this year of what, 6,600. But just quickly winding back, did you think earlier in the year you'd peak too early?
Possibly, albeit that when we spoke, I think in July, we were commenting upon the sort of progress of the market. And we had some wobbles in the summer, some real concerns that we may have headed into a double dip.
Well, to be fair, actually you did say, I think you're on record as saying on Proactive, that you felt that we were just going to skirt it.
That's right, and actually I felt that the market would come to a conclusion fairly quickly. And so the second half was clearly very good. What drove that forecast of 5850, I think, helps drive our forecast for this year of 6600, which comes down simply to the case that businesses are doing well. So we're quite happy with the backdrop at the moment for business. They are producing lots of cash and they are paying out dividends, and income, when you've got interest rates at 0.5%, is an important consideration. The equity market at the moment, and certainly some parts of 2010, was trading, as I say, at a premium yield to government gilts. Now, partially that's driven by the fact that we had a lot of QE and a lot of buying, which I think inflated that particular market. But I think certainly with dividend growth forecasts for 2010, we're quite comfortable 10-15% growth that that would drive a 6600 target without embarrassing valuations.
You're talking about where we move in terms of the overall markets. You've got sterling strength, but in fact you've got that not down to interest rate rises, have you? You're saying no interest rate rise at all this year?
No, albeit that there is some risk to that. And there's no question that I think they would like to remain as accommodative as they can with interest rates, and that is not just the British Bank of England, but obviously globally, to a large extent. But the hand may be forced, and that is coming from inflation at the moment, which is standing sort of stubbornly high at the moment. And there was talk last year that they expected that to be a temporary blip. Well, we're still up there, and we're still well above target. So they're going to, I think, in the tone, going to become more hawkish. And I do appreciate consensus at the moment is that third quarter we'll start to see interest rates go up.
A token rise, some of them.
A token rise. We still think they're going to try and sort of hold back. But as I say, just be prepared that there's some risk to that view.
Okay, you brought three stocks along for us to take a look at today. One is those that you spoke actually about in the summer, Entertainment One. This is a distribution company, isn't it? Content distribution company.
Yes, I think well worth updating. The share price has doubled in 6 months. And why has it doubled? Well, it really is just a reflection. When we identified, we thought the share rating was far too cheap. And of course, by doubling, the share rating has now come up to a more typical media style rating. I still argue it's a little bit cheap, but really the news...
A little bit, what sort of margin, a little bit?
Well, I would say about 15 to 20% under the sector average. But further, what they have added to the profile of the business, in one of their divisions, which is the family division, they own the rights to Peppa Pig. They effectively own that character, and Ben and Holly. And what they've been able to achieve is that they've got some very good traction in the UK market. Merchandise around Peppa Pig was about 150 million in the UK just alone. But they've broken into the US, and they've broken in quite a big way. These numbers will start to impact in 2012, 13, 14 onwards. But I think that the entertainment group deserves certainly a media rating, if not a slight premium to that. So whilst the shares have doubled, the easy money has been made, I think it's still a share that you would tuck away in your pension and still feel quite happy to run with it.
Your second stock is a software company, Sandvine. This is not one I've come across before.
No, it's a Canadian stock, but similar to Entertainment One, actually. Mm-hmm. Entertainment One came out of Canada, so there's a trend there. But Sandvine is quoted in London. It is listed on the AIM market. And the area, it looks like, it works with telecom operators and sits between the telecom operators and the client. So take Vodafone, for example. What its software allows Vodafone to do is more accurately monitor the traffic that is going across its network. Now, as I say, 5 years ago, the traffic was text messaging and fairly conventional sort of viewing of internet. Now, of course, there's so much video that's coming across the traffic. And really what is becoming more pressing and actually more interesting for the telco operators in their charging structure is really to monitor what type of traffic has come across their network, because ultimately I think they would like to be able to differentiate on charging and things like that. So Sandvine is a small company. It's doing quite well. It's got some great names on on its list. And as a business, to put it on some sort of comparable rating to the US market, I can see Sandvine potentially being a double, a stroke, trebler over the course of the next 2 or 3 years.
Okay, we'll take a look at that in some more detail as well, as one worth looking at. But I want to move on if I can. This is a company where, this is a sleeves rolled up company. Titan Europe makes something, yes. Actually manufactures something.
Yes, well, that's the interesting thing. Because very rarely do we find an industrial company to buy in the UK. But this company supplies the construction market, the mining equipment market. Mm-hmm. So its sort of customer base would be companies like Caterpillar and John Deere.
It makes undercarriages and wheels, doesn't it?
That's right, for that particular market. Mm-hmm. So if you subscribe to the view that those markets are recovering, which I do on a global basis, then this company is recovering. The attractive thing, and I do highlight the risk here, is that Titan Europe was a very highly leveraged business, had a lot of debt in within the business, and so the operational gearing in the business is very high, so PE ratings at the moment are sort of 8 times falling to 4 times at the current sort of share price, and as the underlying markets and trading continues to improve, a bit like Entertainment One, we bought something that was on a cheap rating which we felt would go back to a more market rating. So the stock's about 85 pence and we feel a 120 pence sort of re-rating over the course of the next 3 to 6 months is our target. But admittedly, as I say, what we're looking at here, and it's got very similar parallels to what we looked at with Entertainment One, was quite a highly leveraged sort of balance sheet, but operationally geared into a recovering market. And if you think mining and construction are two industries that are doing that, and good trading is strong at the moment, then the equity value will re-rate accordingly.
Okay, Paul, thanks. 3 stocks there worth looking at, and certainly bearing more analysis. That's Paul Kavanagh there from Killik.
This film is for educational and leisure purposes only. Proactive Investors does not provide investment advice. The company is a publisher and is not registered with or authorised by the Financial Services Authority. Please refer to the full terms and conditions on the Proactive Investors website.